而讲到在华人的文化当中，讲到所谓的族谱称谓，其实有很复杂的状况，不只是考倒了一票本地人，更别说是外国旅客。现在网络上出现了这样的相关教学影片，但我们就实际拿给民众来看，但不知道是称谓本身真的是太复杂，还是影片旁白实在讲得太快，大家全都看不懂。这也还真的印证，要搞懂华人的族谱称谓真的很难。
到亲戚家做客，总免不了要打招呼。外婆家的称谓，还有远房亲戚，已经考倒一票台湾人。
那叔公的小孩呢？
叔公的小孩不知道哎，
就会觉得这个很难。
对啊，这哎，祖父上去那边会比较难啊。
妈妈那边的比较不熟。
Okay, now let's get back to your immediate family. Say your siblings get married. Your older sister's husband is called Jiefu. Your older brother's wife is your 嫂子. Your younger sister's husband is your 妹夫。
就是因为中国人族谱实在太复杂，有影片特别制作英文版，要告诉外国人称谓怎么样才是对的。旁白讲得飞快，就算有图示说明，外国人有听没有懂。
If you're a female, then your sister's daughter is 姨生女. But if you're a man, then your sister's daughter is your 外甥女. Okay, now you finally get married. Yay! If you're a dude, your wife is your 老婆. Your wife's dad is called 岳父, and your wife's mom is called 岳母.
宛如鸭子听雷，外国人看了影片，傻眼的傻眼，表情纳闷到不行。
That's complicated to me because I don't know your language.
So this cannot help you to understand the whole Chinese family tree.
Well, I think it was moving a little too fast for me. I think that was more the problem.
毕竟对外国人来说，不管堂哥表哥全都叫 cousin， 叔叔舅舅都叫 uncle， 姑姑阿姨都叫 auntie。但在台湾要把族谱称谓全写出来，可能连一张 A4 纸都不够。台湾人都举手投降的族谱称谓，就算介绍影片讲得再详细，还是英文发音，但听在老外耳里恐怕还是一头雾水。中央新闻唐奕晨、刘志军台北采访报道。